organizing committee, I would like to extend
a warm welcome to all of you in this auditorium. Ladies and gentlemen, before we begin, we seek your kind cooperation to switch off your handphone or have it on silent mode. Thank you. A very good afternoon to our honorable speaker, Mr. Bak Stan, and distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the organizing committee, I would like to extend a warm welcome to all of you. Ladies and gentlemen, we are honored to have with us today Mr. Bak Stan. Mr. Bak Stan has 14 national awards to his name. He received the National Innovation Award from the Prime Minister in 2007. In 2009, India honored him with an International Excellence Award for Innovation. This is a recognition for his contribution to the field of creativity and innovation. Mr. Bak Stan is also a judge for the James Dyson Award, an international invention competition held over 18 countries. He is also a celebrity judge for Ideas Malaysia Interventors Challenge, a reality TV show broadcasted on TV3. Without further delay, ladies and gentlemen, let us extend our warmest welcome to Mr. Bak Stan. With his talk, wrap up your thinking skills.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, everybody. Looks like we got a very big crowd. And I got a whole, whole auditorium to myself. Well, I guess we have got about 2 hours, right? 2 hours or so. So we'll try to make it as cozy as possible. So you can ask me any question along the way, right? So today I'm going to share with you my personal experience as an inventor, how I came about ideas and how I turned those ideas into reality. I will play a few videos also, just to let you know. And I have got 2 sets of slides. First set of slides, I talk about myself and my achievement. And the second set of slides, I talk about a thinking technique. A thinking technique means you take these techniques home, and then you can use the technique to come out ideas. All right? So maybe we can show of hand. Anyone here is an inventor? No. Okay, anyone here has got idea? You got idea, right? So now let's see how we can improve on that, okay? Maybe we start off talking about myself first. And because this is not a big crowd, so I think along the way, if you have a question, you just raise your hand and ask me. Much better, right? Okay, so my name is Bak Stan, and I'm an award-winning inventor. So you want to know why my name is Bak Stan? This is the most frequent question asked. So they want to know what's my, why my name is Bak Stan, not my Chinese name. My Chinese name, I think I didn't know, Stan Yong Kia. But because I was in school, so my friends say I look like Bugs Bunny. I think like Bugs Bunny. So they call me Bugs. So that name stuck in me. That name stuck in me. And then when I go to work, I try to use Tan Yao Kia, but nobody wants to use that name. Everybody call me Bak Stan. Even my mother cannot speak English. He will call my office. Hello, can I speak to Bak Stan? So even my mother also calls me Bak Stan. So that's funny. I'm 50. I'm a Malaysian, right? And I'm happily married. Now that's very important. I wrote that happily married is because you know, our mind is important. If we are happy, we cannot be unhappy. And if we are unhappy, we cannot be happy. Am I right? So that's only with the mechanics of the mind, the behaviors, we can only do one thing at a time. So with that, I have to tell you, I'm happily married. Although my wife and I always quarrel, but I try to be cool and say I'm happily married. Because with a happy mind, with a more relaxed mind, I can think, alright? So if you have boyfriend who kacau you all the time, well, let him win, you know? That's what I do. My wife, I tell her, you want to win, you're very good. Because I just want to be free, you know?
be free from all those unnecessary arguments. I'm a full-time inventor. I invent things right from the many years ago, more than 13 or 15 years ago, I was doing invention. And I'm also a surrogate mother. You know what's a surrogate mother? Surrogate mother are those mother who lend the womb, you know, to a couple. Those couple cannot have their own baby, right? So they hire the womb to give, you know, to conceive for a baby. So in my case, it's the same. There are a lot of companies outside there, and then they cannot conceive idea because they are very busy in their work, you know. So they say, okay, Mr. Bucks, you come, we want to hire your brain. So when they want to hire my brain, so my brain is on hire, so I'm going to listen to them to see what they want me to invent, you know. Because they know the market, but they don't know how to get it done. So they tell me what they want, and then within a few months, you know, we agree on certain terms and so forth, and I will then deliver the idea to them. So that's why I'm a surrogate mother, right? So this is the first time you see a surrogate mother, a man surrogate mother, right? Alright. I have many patents in my name. I'm also an innovation advisor to UCSI University, to a few companies as well. I'm a judge. I'm an adjunct lecturer at UTP, University of Technology, Petronas. And I'm a Dhamma speaker. Do you know what's a Dhamma speaker? Anyone know? No. A Dhamma speaker is like Ustaz, you know, in Muslim Islam. So I go to other temples. I deliver the words of the Buddha. So that's one of the things I do that on weekend. And I'm a former cricket player. I play for the country. I put it there is because to tell you that the championship material that I have today came from sport. Not just because, you know, I'm clever or I'm just born clever. It's not like that. It's through the sports, you know, I learned how to play to win. So that gave me a lot of a lot of training. And I live by these three simple principles. I avoid evil, I do good, and I purify my mind. That's very simple. But you try doing it and see whether you can or not. I hope you can, because you know, if you can do that, then your mind is free, and then you make this world a better place. That's what I do. I want to make this world a better place. Okay, maybe I play a small video. This is just shown a few months ago on a TV3. TV1. Thank you. 2001, I won the silver medal in Geneva. Then year 2000, I won the National Inventor Award from the Ministry of Science. Then I shortlisted, and as you can see here, all over. So I've got from India as well, America, and Korea, and the last one was just last week. I was inducted in the Hall of Fame in the University of Technology. Malaysia, it's Kudai. So, well, I think, you know, it's not so difficult to get, you know, if you put your mind into it. I was at one of my friend's office yesterday. He calls all his staff, you know, about 60 or 70 of them. And then he asked me to sit in front. You know? Then he said, Mr. Park, I have to interview you. So that we want to take out your mind. We want to see how you work, you know. And let the company staff understand you. So he started off by saying, Mr. Bucks, which university you go? I said, no, I've never gone to any university. Then he asked, anyone never go to university? No, everybody go to university. How come you can get so many awards and how come my staff can get any award? What's the secret? You know? So he actually grilled me for 1 hour, more than 1 hour, 1.5 hours. So he asked me, you know, how idea came about and so forth. And I tell him, look, I'm just a normal guy. Because I don't have a certificate, like most of you have. So because I don't have a certificate, I gotta work harder because I don't have the knowledge. So everything I do, I must go and look for it. And I'm also lucky, you know, because I got so many UST that I'm associated with now. So each time I go, then the research assistant will do the work for me now. So it's easy for me. So that's how I do. And then another question they asked me was, because my children are also innovative, so they want to know whether is a person naturally born innovative, or you have to teach your child to be innovative. Right? That was the question asked. So I say it's both. It's both. For example, in my case, my IQ is 126. So to get a genius is 130, so I'm almost there. But I'm telling you, there's nothing unusual about it. Because most of us has got above 100. You know, most of us. Just that you never discover yourself and you don't know that you have that kind of IQ. So in my case, I already know the potential of mine. Because I know the potential of mine, then I use it on my children, you know? I use it on my children. These are my children. These are my children. Amanda is now from 5. She just finished from 5. So she's going to New Zealand. And Emily is from 4 now. and they are also inventor. Amanda has got 4 national awards. And Amelia got 7 national awards.
You see?
So, not so difficult. And both of them are in the Standard 4 Armani Science School. And they are featured as a scientist master department. So all the children in Standard 4, they know my cooking. Alright? So if you have a mind, who doesn't have a mind, put up a hand. So everybody have a mind, right? So because, the word manusia, come from the root word called manusa. Manusa is in Sanskrit. Manusa come from two words, manu and usa. Manu means the mind. Usa, like in Bahasa Malaysia, means, to do the best, to cultivate. So we are the human being that has a mind that can cultivate to the full potential. So when I discover that, then every time I use my mind to think. Alright? So you also have your mind. So the most important tool is your mind, right? Okay. So when my kid was small, I tell them to invent, to give me 1 idea a month. Right? You can do that with your children also. Get 1 idea a month. And today they have got more idea than me, because satu bulan satu idea lah. So today they are grown up, they have got more idea than me. And they know very well that this world is not a perfect place, right? So because this world is not a perfect place, so it gives the opportunity for them to invent things. Okay, so you have seen the compost pool. This is a singing donation box. It's a, you put money and then there's a song come out. Thank you, the river gods. Then people get shocked. Then they want to hear some more, then they put more money. That's how to get more money. Right? And this is a heated swimsuit. Where we live in the condominium. So every time when she goes swimming here, Sesama, then she falls sick. So the mother said, can swim. So one day she brought the swimsuit. He said, Daddy, you put some wire, put battery, then I become warm. So with that, she got a silver medal from Korea. She also got a special award from Vietnam. And this is a car toilet seat, and this is a real story. Alright, every time we go out station, they was asking her, Daddy, stop the car. Then the two girls will go out and do their business. I said, hey, come on, this is embarrassing, I think of something. So, and then she says, she brought her potty to me, she said, Daddy, can you cut a hole in your car? Yeah. But this is something parents should also learn. Never say crazy idea. And never say stupid idea. The minute you say that, then you kill the effort and you kill the imagination, right? So what I did was I said, let me think about it. So then I went and bought a $20 seat from the junkyard. I cut a hole and she went for exhibition. But she didn't win. But because you are helping her and all that, their confidence also grew, right? So you as parents also try to help your child. Now that's Amanda. Amanda has came up with the idea of doing a vibrating earring for the deaf child. Meaning the child tak boleh dengar, so the mother will use the remote control. So if the left ear vibrate, that means mommy call. If the right ear vibrate, means go makan. So for that she win more or more. So anyway, I was just trying to tell you these are all normal playful kids. So you don't have to have 7 A's or 10 A's to be a mentor. You're just normal kid, right? Just like me, I'm just a normal person. Okay? I hope I can give you some encouragement. Okay, now I also want to, I also want to give you a little bit of science about creativity. You have to understand when the idea is developed, what do you do with the idea from the process. So you start off with imagination, right? So what is creativity? Anyone can give a guess? Creativity is an idea that other people have not thought of it yet. So it's imagination, right? So they start off with creativity. Right? For example, this is my daughter's creative thought. She says, you can put oil and then a fire can zoom. Then the button, if you push the button, can change color. Right? So when you give things like that, you don't say crazy idea, but you say, oh, fantastic. This is why I said, fantastic, give me another one, right? So these are the other ideas of children have. Okay. So anyone here have used Nokia? Anyone here use Nokia? You use Nokia. You like your Nokia phone or not? Okay. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to show what Nokia has, and then later you tell me whether you like your Nokia phone or not. Okay, this is what Nokia has in India, research lab. Okay, this is the flip color I'm talking about. So this is also an invention. It has not gone into the market yet. Let me show you.
Okay, recording again.
Recording again.
You can go to that. YouTube. Yeah. Go. All right, I'm doing it. Flash.
Banana is to stimulate the okay. Courtesy okay. Just to test, to do a demonstration.
Alright, okay. Okay, good.
Yeah. So this is taken in Johor. The inventor is Johor. Do you think it's a good invention? It has got two main features. The first feature is when you flip up, you save the space. So once it saves the space, you can do shower or wash your clothes, right? And second is when you flush, because of the gravity, use less water, use less by 3 liters. Instead of 7 liters, you use 4 liters, so you save 3 liters. So these are the two main features. And these are just invention, these are good ideas. Right? So it's good for a country like, say, Singapore, Hong Kong, or Tokyo, where you know the price of the city is expensive, so you use this. Okay, now I want to show you one of the inventions that I've done. This is Technology Park, this is where I work, alright? This is the design for Toyota car.
So what we do, we pull it out, and then we get a last day. So the idea is when you go out to the market to buy fruits or to buy vegetables, that is how you find them. I just give you some example of the food cycle. Things like this, and I'll show you more things like that. And then you put this inside the basket.
Saturday, no plastic bag.
Then you use it, huh?
Then you push it out, then you drive home. So when you drive home, the idea is the things in the basket, they don't fall apart. They are always in the basket. Okay? So when you reach home, you open up, then you take your things out of the basket.
Is that a good idea? Yeah. And this one is Toyota, they has got a vendor. So the vendor engaged me as a surrogate mother to come up with. So I cannot sell, because the idea belongs to them. Right? And this is I designed for two, for Vios and for Camry. Yeah. So next time when you buy a Vios or Camry, you get one of these. Right? Okay, I move on. We talk about creativity, we talk about invention, now we talk about innovation, right? So this is how it flows, you know? From an idea to marketplace, this is how it flows, right? So what is innovation? An innovation is a new invention that has been mass produced and sold in the marketplace. Like what? Like iPad, right? This one everybody knows, everybody. So even a software is also innovation. When it's, right? For example, this one I download, I pay 99 cents. So it's considered already in the market. Okay, these are some of the popular innovation that you have seen, right? So that's a fan without blade. Have you seen? You have seen, right? No, you have not seen. Yes, the air goes in from the side here. The air goes in from the side here, then it goes up, and the wing here, it has got this small air push, and then it's like an aeroplane kind of shape. So when you push that way, and then you draw 7 times more air. So if you are facing here, then you get
no blade.
So apply to you. Fantastic. And that guy's name is James Dyson. James Dyson is from England. He's also like me. He's an inventor, but of course he's a lot more successful. And he is now the innovation advisor to David Cameron, the Prime Minister of the UK. So he also invented this vacuum cleaner yang tak ada backless. So he came up with a design called Cyclone. So with the Cyclone, it's able to take out dirt from the air. And with that, the dirt goes into a container, then you buka saja, dia berbuang. So there's no bag required, and that way you get more dirt. So he's a fantastic guy. So he has sold, in fact, he's a Dyson vacuum. He's number one brand in UK, number one brand in Japan, number one brand in US. He captured the vacuum market. Okay, these are all the innovation that I think you have seen. Okay, maybe I want to show the future innovation that will be coming very soon. This is by Samsung. Let's take a look.
This is my favorite thing of the show. This is the Samsung transparent smart window. So it looks like a normal screen, but I can actually do things like make this blinds. So I can close the blinds. I can actually see through to the little town outside. If I want to hit widget, I can check out Twitter. I can check the forecast for Vegas. This is so freaking cool. This is future technology right here. It's a one-sided pane, which means people can't walk by your kitchen window, see what you're looking at, so you don't have to worry about that. I know that it's going into the coming months, the mass production of the coming months, so we're going to start seeing stuff like this ASAP, and I'm pretty excited about it because Well, quite frankly, I feel like I'm in Minority Report, and that's really awesome.
Fantastic, yeah, that's awesome. So you see the glass of the glass, as far as we know, it's only for window and for door. You know, but now glass has, when you put technology into glass, there are so many things you can do with a piece of glass. Right? And this actually is also another video on glass, but I'm going to skip this. It's quite a long video. Right? Okay, this is how to get me. Right? I got a Facebook there, and you want to add me? Then I got another Facebook, Stroke Uncle Bugs. That's for parents and teachers. Parents and children and teachers as well. And then every Friday I give a tip for inventor. Right? Then I got the Blogspot where, you know, I put my thoughts on creativity. And that's my email address, bugstan@gmail.com. And of course I got my Buddhist site as well. So I've got I got about 2,800 friends here. And at the Blogspot I got 130,000 hits. And Buddhist blog I got more, I got 230,000 hits. So I used to joke with my friend, I said if I become a monk, I'll be a better monk than a mentor. Yeah, this is how you get me, alright? Don't feel shy, contact me anytime. But don't call me at night too late because I sleep at 10:30. Alright? And then what I do is on a Saturday morning, I allocate my time, 2 hours, to talk to people, anybody. So there are a lot of students come and see me. So what I do is, okay, you go to a Starbucks, right? So they ask me any question. So that's my contribution to the nation. Okay. Yeah, more customer now. Okay, yeah, you have written down? Right. So any question for me so far? Before I go to the next slide?
Yes.
Great to say next.
Yeah.
Do you have any challenges regarding
copyright? Okay.
It's very difficult information.
Yeah.
It's very costly.
Yeah, so for invention, we don't do copyright, we file a patent. Yeah, we file a patent, so the idea belongs to me. So he cannot steal my idea, she cannot steal my idea. I think quite okay. So what I do, I file a patent. But before I file a patent, I want to make sure, because I got many ideas. I cannot file a patent for every idea, I go bankrupt. You know, it's very expensive. One time I filed, it cost $8,000. $8,000 ringgit. So I must make sure the idea got commercial value. So I have to weigh. I must make sure I can make the money, then I file the patent. If I cannot make the money, I don't file the patent. If you want to copy, I let you copy. Because it has got no value. You understand? So not every idea I have to file a patent. Yes, in Malaysia we have 20 years. In America it's 15 years.
So
you have an idea. Okay, then it's expensive. Malaysia is a treaty of the PCT Convention Treaty, a signatory of that. So meaning whatever you file, they will recognize. So, but you still need to file in America if you think you want to target America. You still need to file in China if you want to do in China. So each time you file, you pay money. So depending which country you want to go. So it can cost you $100,000. Global 300,000. Oh, at least 300,000. A lot of money, that's why. I'm a poor man. You got it?
Yeah.
Okay, and anyway, intellectual property consists of many things. Huh? So intellectual property consists of patent, consists of copyright. Copyright is like artistic work, drawing, songs, animation. It's copyright. So copyright, you don't have to register, you don't have to pay money. You just put a C, then put a round around it. You've seen before, right? Put your name, put a date. That belongs to you. Alright? That's called copyright. Then other patent, other kind of industrial, intellectual property consists of trademark. I brand. Nike is a patent, is a trademark. Then the other thing is industrial design. right? For example, this the shape looks like that. You have seen the chair looks like that from the side. So if you have file industrial design, so a person cannot be the same chair as yours, right? So there are many things. I can talk about it another time, you know, just to cover this. Any question? I got one question people used to ask me. Mr. Bax, what are the inventions that you want to do but you have not done yet? that's one of the questions. So I used to joke, I wish I can invent a wallet. I wish I can invent a wallet. I open every time I got money. Not money, I open, they got money. that's what I wish, but that doesn't happen. Alright? Okay, so we move on to the second part of the program today, whereby I will share with you a technique, you know? This is a technique, right? Okay, this is a technique to teach you a method, bagaimana nak fikir, how to generate ideas, okay? So before that, we talk about thinking, how thinking come along. So this Robert Heinlein, he's a scientist, he's a science fiction writer. He said that human beings are made of three types of people, group A, group B, group C. Okay, let's investigate. Group A. Group A, 5% of population simply cannot think. I hope you don't fall into this category. And then group B are 5% who can think and can do also. Correct? And also another C, 90% can think but don't do. Betul lah. Now you tell me they are which group? Right? Like this guy here. He can think but he don't do. Alright? And then I also want to explain to you. People get confused, you know, the brain and the mind. So I have to explain to you what's the difference between the brain and the mind, okay? While a human brain is a hardware, the mind is a software, correct? Something like that, right? Something like that. So that's the difference. As you can see, the elephant brain is a big brain, but because they don't have a mind, right? Mind is a software. So your brain, your size can be small, but if you've got a strong mind, you're still very powerful, okay? So how does the mind work? The mind works because we got sense organ. Excuse me, what have you got? You got eyes to see, am I right? Then you have got ears to hear. You have got body to touch. You have got tongue to taste. You have got nose for smelling. And when the mind receives information from these five sense doors, this is where consciousness takes place. You got it? You got it? Maybe you want to go further a bit. I want to talk about the mind. Well, this mind that we have here is actually the most powerful tool in the world, you know. Just now I mentioned about manusia, right? Manusia. So manusia actually made of a human body, right? Rupa. Rupa is the human body and the mind. So the mind has got four faculties. The first faculty is the sense organ, as you can see here, the sense organ. The second faculty is the memory. That means that what I'm trying to say is these are sense organs, these are sense doors. They only receive outside information into the mind, into you. You got it? When you receive information into you, like for example, now you hear my voice, right? And you saw my face. So what happened? It goes into your memory. Then your memory do the matching. Matching of the voice, matching of my face. That's the second faculty. Then the third faculty is your feelings. Feelings means what? Feelings happy, feelings sad, plus also neutral feelings. So this is your feeling. How you feel about Mr. Buck's voice? Is it sweet? Is it too loud? Is it too soft? Right? Is his face ugly? Or is it too tall? Is it too short? Things like that.
Then after that, you go to the fourth faculty, which is actually your thinking mind. Your thinking mind is where it processes, like a hardware. It processes all this information and then you connect to all your other memories and all your others, your knowledge, and you connect and see how to respond to it. You got it? Yeah. So this is how powerful we are. The trouble is that we hardly use. But just tadi saya cakap lah, all of us actually are genius, just that we didn't know how to use. Okay? So I emphasize on the mind as well, because the mind is the most powerful equipment, but nobody use it. We are very ignorant about it. Right? Okay, so I hope you can understand about the mind. And this is what Tony Buzan says. Tony Buzan came here a few times, right? I remember he came here, I also attended to one of his talks. Interesting guy. He said the mind is about 1.5 kg, right? It's slightly bigger than our fist, 1.5 kg. And there are, say, 1 billion neurons, brain cells. Betul? 1 billion ke 1 trillion? I think 1 trillion, huh? So many zeros. And the possible permutation, that means the connection. Tadi saya cakap, when you, how to respond, there are 1 billion connections, how to respond, right? But he says the trouble is that there's only 1% is used. Ah. Because most of us, we are too lazy. Kita terlalu malas nak kerja. Terlalu malas nak fikir. That's our problem. Okay? So, our brain, we only use 1%. But what's a good point? What's a good point? The good point is 99% not use it. That's a good point. Okay? So now you know you got 99% not use. So go home and use it. Right? Yeah. Okay, this is another guy which I think is very famous. You should know him, Dr. Edward Bono. He mentioned that the main function, he asked, what is the main function of the brain, the mind? Okay. So anyone can give me the answer? He said that it is a self-organizing information system. Betul tak? It is whatever you put in, surely it comes out. Because it's self-organized. It is what we say, you know, made upstairs, right? And it's always active. Even while you're sleeping also it's active. That's why you get dreams. Now you understand where dreams come from? Because of these permutations at the back, your conscience is still working, right? So that's why you get dreams. You got any question along the way, just raise your hand, you know? Because we have a lot of time, you know, do an interaction, and this is not a big crowd, so it's quite manageable. And due to our habits of our mind, we create patterns in the things we do in our life. Correct? Sometimes when you drive, and normally this is the way to drive to office, but on today you want to drive to the children's school, but you forget you just go to office. Because you know, this is the pattern that we have, the pattern of the mindset. So if you are always lazy, the pattern is lazy, so you got to change. This is almost brain, it's too small. Okay, I move on. Okay, today we're going to talk about the thinking tool which I'm going to teach you. It's called, it starts with C. And now S-C-A-M-P-E-R. Scamper, alright? You may want to write this down, Scamper. Because this Scamper is a tool. It's a tool to teach you how to think, right? Oh, okay. S for substitute. You want to write that? C for combine. A for adapt. M for modify or magnify. P for put to other uses. E for eliminate or minify. Eliminate means don't do lah. Tak mau lagi ya. R stand for reverse, rearrange or reuse also can. You got it? Everybody got it? Yeah. I cannot hear.
camper, yeah. Yeah, created by somebody. Yeah, I don't use it, but I find it very easy for starter like you. So that you can use this tool to come up with an idea. In my case, I don't use this. I have other methods. But it's good for students and especially graduates like that. Right? It's Kempa. It's actually created by American starter. Okay, I'm going to go on to teach you how to use this Kempa. So as for what substitute, right? So what happens is when you are faced with a problem, you ask yourself this question. What or who can you substitute? Like for example, your boss or your lecturer. Can a lecturer be substituted? Can or not? Can, clever. Can your bicycle be substituted? Can, right? Yeah. So there's so many things can be substituted. Can you change the rules? Can you use other ingredients, especially when you're cooking, you know? You substitute with something else, huh? Can you also use other process, other procedures, you know? You substitute with something else. What else, right? So S, can you think of a replacement? Okay, so I'm going to show you an example of what can be substituted. I'm going to give you in each words, I'm going to tell you a product and a process. So for example, this is a bicycle. Who can think a bicycle be substituted by what? What can a substitute, bicycle be substituted? Okay, I'll show you. Bicycle is now substituted by Segway. What is that? Yeah, you see this, right? Yes. So there's so many things you can substitute, right? Now I'm going to show you a process. This is air ticket. This is a boarding pass. Is it substituted by what? Who can give me an idea? Is it substituted by a self-printed online ticket? So if you are doing something, then you ask yourself whether it can be substituted. Right? So there's S, substituting. Okay, we move on to combine. So when you're faced with a problem, you ask yourself this question. Ideas can be combined, can or not? Ideas can be combined. The purpose for it to be combined, how to blend, how to mix, how to, you know, combine together. For example, this is I move back, so you write combine. Okay, for example, this is a culinary set, right? Culinary set. So you're still having an individual fork, or a spoon, or a knife, or a pair of chopsticks, you know? You can have a combo spoon that can change into whatever combination that you want. You saw that? You can change from a chopstick to a fork, or a fork to a knife. So this is my daughter's invention. When she was 10 years old, she came up with this invention. And she got a gold medal. She came up with this invention because, not because of this, you know. Because she go to the hawker stall and the fork and spoon dirty. So because the hawker fork and spoon dirty, she has to use her own. But her own from the house is very big. So they say, okay, I'm going to make it to half. So that's how the product came out. So is it a clever idea? I think so. Okay, we go to the next one. We see what we can combine. Okay, a post office used to sell stamp. Now the post office actually offer anything, right? What can they do? I used to go there to renew my road tax. You can pay your bills, right? Yeah. So this is what they can do. They can do anything. Okay, and then next is and then. What else is like this? And then what other idea? That's why you always ask suggestion from the kawan. Hey, come on, give me some idea, right? And what is the lesson you learned from your past? So the idea that you put into your future invention. And copy also adapt, correct? Yeah. And Japanese is very good at that. Am I right?
Japan is very good. Of course, China also very good at that. And that is not too bad because by being at that, you copy. Become copy economy, you can be. In fact, China now has replaced Japan as the second largest economy in the world. And because of this adaptation. So it's very important that we adapt. Okay, we talk about the example of adapt. KFC. Dulu, KFC dia jual ayam saja kan? So instead of just selling the Western meal, now they adapt to local taste. Am I right? Last time it's called Kentucky Fried Chicken. Now it's no more called Kentucky Fried Chicken. You know why? Because they sell bubur. So they have to kill KFC. Okay, now that's product. Let's look at process. How can process be adapted? Right? Foreign banks are now adapting themselves into local scenes. Local scene, sorry. So they can capture the market share. Yeah? You saw this, right? So they learn how to drink data. Because they want to get into the market, so they got to adapt. Right? Okay, we move on to the next one. Magnify. M. We cover S, C, A, M. M, right? So you have to ask yourself, what can be enlarged? What can be exaggerated? What we can add on, right? What other value we can add on? And of course, we can also duplicate. So this falls under M. Right, for example, this one. This is the, what do you call it? This is the iPad, right? Now, this is what happened. When you adapt an iPad into a vending machine, you get a very big vending machine. So now here, you can select any drink you want, just touch. Yeah. So this one is what I designed for my friend. I used a 42-inch LCD TV screen. So now you can actually pay online. You can what do you call it? Have a space out there for advertisement, you know. So yes, it brings a lot of benefit. Maybe I show you. That's a video. He's the astronaut Major Faiz. But he didn't get to go to the moon. He didn't go to the moon. Just now I talk about the product, how to magnify from a small iPad into a vending machine. In the process, what happened? In the process, for example, AirAsia. AirAsia is the number one travel website with 20 million unique visitors a month in 6 languages. So they have expanded their business into online shopping megastore. You see? You got it? So this is how they magnify. Because they have already a lot of customers, a lot of traffic. So they have gone into other kind of business, right? This is how it goes. Okay, P. We finish S, C, A, M, P. The next word is P, right? Put to other use. What else, you know, can you use? You can also reuse, you know. Put to other use or reuse. An extension as well. Alright, so for example, our bottle. Bottle. Biasa kita minum habis kita buang kan? Okay, let's see what you can use. In the Philippines, used bottle are used as a solar bottle. And this is to bring lights to people who cannot afford the electric bill. Like this. I got a video on this. Let me play the video for you. This is also quite interesting.
It was 36 degrees Celsius outside and the sun did not show brighter. But in the Asaikama residence in the town of San Pedro, just south of Manila, you'd never guess what time of the day it was. The heat of the summer could be felt inside the house, alright, but none of the sunlight could get in. In every corner of the house, there was just darkness.
What if you just wanted to get some water? We'd have to turn on the light.
It had been that way for years, but that's about to change. Devin Bukas and his sons have come to install lights. Not like the electric bulbs they already have, but ones that are cheap, healthy, and energy efficient.
People in this community used to never see the light of day in their homes. They had a soda bottle, water, and simple tools. They never had to live in darkness anymore.
The technology is amazingly simple. All we have to do is fit the metal sheet around the plastic bottle, fill it with water, add a chlorine, bear a hole on the roof, insert the bottle, and seal it. There you have it. 55 watts of clean and free solar light.
Is it? 55 watts of light. Free.
The genius behind the idea is social entrepreneur Pilar Diaz. Since the project began over a month ago, solar bottle lights have been installed in close to 1,000 households.
It's becoming something that is becoming the new standard of living here. Why should we be trapped in darkness when we can now have the independence to improve our own households with a copyable and such a replicable kind of system?
The system not only provides natural lighting, but it breathes new life to plastic bottles that otherwise would have ended up in dumps. It also aims to create so-called green jobs. Denny earns a little over $1 for every bottle light he installs. Business is just so good that he had to quit his job.
How is that about how you pay?
Almost everyone wants to have it. Demand has been so huge that I have to tell others to when I run out of materials.
He was also one of the first ones to have solar bottle lights installed in his house. The savings have been significant.
If I was to afford it,
it can go into better things like books, nutrition, you know, livelihood.
Ila hopes to be able to light 1 million homes in the Philippines by next year. And in the future, take it to other developing countries as well. Third world solution to third world problems. On Milo CCTV, Manila.
Simple. Yeah. I had it on my blog, and then the Kementerian Science and Technology saw it. They adopt it in Sarawak. Yeah, the longhouse in Sarawak now is using this. Fantastic.
What is the system on it? Water and chlorine.
Water, chlorine, or just bleach?
Bleach.
You can put bleach or chlorine, whichever you have.
Right.
To prevent it from growth. You know, those algae. So when light is shine, then you deflect, so the whole room can see.
So this is called a deflection of the light, huh?
Deflection.
Not because the chlorine get
minerals. No, once the light goes in, it reflects in all directions. Clever idea, but it's not my idea. But I think it's a fantastic idea. So as you can see, if you know how to put it to good use, you can help a lot of people have a better life. Okay, we move on. This is another example of process to put other use. As you can see, this is just a small little torchlight, camera light actually, but it can also be used in a sixth sense. Have you heard of sixth sense technology? No, you have not heard. Okay, sixth sense technology works this way. You got a camera here, and then you got a marker. This is your marker here. Alright? So once your camera shines on the marker, then it will actually focus on the marker, and then you will take back, you know, the information that this camera will take back into your memory, your PC here and so forth. And your PC then will generate whatever information that you need. For example, you put onto your hand, and because it recognizes you see, for example, this thumb here, then you click here, then it recognizes that you're trying to call. Fantastic. So it can recognize you. Anywhere you can go, and you can, and yeah. This is not even have a phone at all. Yeah. And this is mentioned by one Indian. His name is Pranik, and he graduated from America MIT. So he's fantastic. I saw a few of his inventions. And he's so big man, you know. He said, look, I'm not going to file a patent because I want everybody to use. So a fantastic guy. So money doesn't drive him. So he's a fantastic guy. All right, so next is E. E stands for eliminate. Eliminate. So we see how we can actually minimize, condense, compact, omit, delete, and divide, separate, and of course if you can, totally don't use at all. Okay, let's take for example, fan. Just now I mentioned about the fan. This fan has got blade, right? So now we have got fan without blade. Okay, fantastic. Okay, let's think about the process. Remember we have library. In fact, this photo is at University Technology Petronas. Oh, the library is one of the most beautiful library I've ever seen in my whole life. But library will be replaced by Google, by Wikipedia, by Yahoo. So eventually the pustakaan will run out of business. The way I look at it. The scamper, S-C-A-M-P-E-R, this is the last letter of the scamper. It says we can actually reverse, rearrange, reuse, transpose to positive or negative. We can use opposite, we can rearrange it around, upside down, backward, whatever way. We can reverse the role, right? Am I right? So this is one of the ideas that I have, rainwater. Rainwater can be harvested. Am I right? Kalau tidak hujan, dia masuk longkang dan disturb. Actually, this is not my invention. It's one of my friend's invention. So he has came up with a rainwater harvesting collection. Let me explain. So when the rain goes into the gutter, right, it goes both to the gutter. Then there's no motor here because of this. This is higher than this. Can you see here? This is higher. So the water goes back. You got it? Yeah. The water goes back. So when it's full, okay, now this is another control valve. This is another control valve. So what happens, this control valve will control the level here. And then you can use it for your garden or your toilet. Because rainwater is acidic, you know. So you cannot use for drinking. Right? And then if this, let's say musim kemarau, tak ada hujan kan, 3 bulan tak ada hujan. This one empty, and then this water will come and give it to this. So this is the only system that doesn't need a pump. Yeah, fantastic, yeah? Okay, example of process of rearrangement, rearrange. For example, the university. A student in Malaysia now can take his education in a foreign country without having to leave the country. Betul tak? Yeah, now all the universities are here. Okay? I think we have gone through all of it. So let's revise. S for substitute, right? Come share with me. S, C for
combine. A for Adele. SCM for
magnify.
B for put to other use. E for eliminate. R for reverse. So now you all can think again. You can go back and then have one idea a month at least minimum. Okay, now before I go, let's see what these people are saying. Are our ideas crazy or not? Because sometimes we dare not to tell those ideas. People may laugh at us. Huh? Every time I tell ideas, some of my friends laugh at us. But this is what Albert de Bono says. He says, all new ideas and inventions are logical only on the... Okay, who can tell me the last word? All new ideas and inventions are logical only on the hindsight, correct? It means only when it is done, used, then it's only logical. When it's new, it's still crazy, right? Okay, I think I've finished my talk for the day. So, and before I go, any questions? Get on the lights, get on the lights. So, did you benefit from this talk? You benefited a little bit. Hopefully, you benefit. You can go back and think, you know, anything you see, the place where you play, or the place where you work, the place where you at home, you know, these are the places where look for ideas. And I often got one question from the crowd. They always ask, Mr. Bucks, what time of the day you think best? Is it in the toilet? What do you think? Give a guess. What do you think my answer will be? What time of the day I think best? Or what time?
Before
to sleep. No. Wrong answer.
When you first wake up.
When I first wake up. No. Wrong answer.
Dreaming.
Dreaming. Yeah. I don't even know. Watching TV?
No. Looking at a pilot boat.
What boat?
Looking at a pilot boat.
No.
Dreaming?
No. Okay, my answer is this. I don't have a specific time. I don't know. But I think best when I'm most relaxed. When my mind is most relaxed, that's where I can think. So it can be driving, or it can be in a toilet bowl. Especially driving, because when I drive a long distance, all ideas comes. And while watching TV also, while I'm dreaming, not watching TV, but I'm dreaming, ideas come. But I must be relaxed. If I'm not relaxed, if I have a project, I cannot think. So that's why I don't care about timeline. I don't get, the timeline worries me. So I'm relaxed. The minute I'm relaxed, I do it, then I will make the timeline. Okay, any questions? You have a question for me? Alright, so I think it's about time. Okay, thank you. So you have been a very wonderful audience, and then I wish you good luck.
Thank you, Mr. Bucks Tan, for your valuable sharing and insights on wrap up your thinking skills. We would like to invite Mr. Sia Kangan, Assistant General Manager, Center for Extension Education, to present a token of appreciation to Mr. Bucks Tan.
Thank you, Mr.
Bucks-san.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the end of today's talk. We wish to thank Mr. Bucks-san for being with us today and sharing his expertise and knowledge with us.